Ali Baba and the 40 Thieves. Ali Baba was cutting wood in the forest. He heard the sound of horses walking from the road. He got scared. He climbed a nearby tree and hid. He looked and saw that 40 men were riding on horses. 40 riders reached a rock in the bright sunlight. Ali Baba could clearly see his glittering bags full of gold. Those bags are full of stolen treasure. Then their leader called out, "Open Sesame!" And then suddenly a huge secret door opened in the rock. 40 riders entered. When they were all inside, the leader yelled, "Shut up, Sesame!" The secret door closed. Ali Baba was still waiting, hidden in the top of his tree. Then all the riders came out of the cave. The leader yelled, "Shut up, Sesame!" The secret door closed. Ali Baba peeked out from behind the leaves. The thieves put the empty bags on their horses and set off. Ali Baba waited for them to leave. He wondered if the magic door would open for him if he spoke the special words that the leader of the thieves had said. Ali Baba looked at the rocky cliff and thought about all the treasure inside. He went to the rock and said, "Khul ja Sesame!" And then suddenly the door opened. Ali Baba repeated those words again, "Shut down," and the door was closed. In the treasure cave, Ali Baba looked around in surprise. There was a heaps of glittering jewels and piles of gold coins. Ali Baba was surrounded by jewels and gold. He was not greedy. He did not want jewelry. All he wanted was a small gold coins to buy food for himself and his family. So Ali Baba took one and ran down the stone step and came to the door and said, "Open up." Immediately the magical door opened. He hurried up. Then he called, "Shut up, Sesame!" The door was closed. Ali Baba thanked him and left. But Ali Baba's brother Qasim also came to collect wood. He saw Ali Baba coming out of the cave and saying magic words. He asked Ali Baba, "What is this magic?" Ali Baba showed Qasim the gold. Ali Baba told his brother and said that 40 thieves will be back soon. So they both hurried home. Qasim told his wife all that he had seen about his brother Ali Baba. So his wife said, "Qasim, go back and bring me a gold coins." Qasim went to this cave. In front of the rock, Qasim spoke the magic words, "Open up." When the secret door opened, Qasim entered quickly. He spoke the magic words to close the door shut down. Qasim ran towards the stairs. His eyes light up when he saw all the glittering jewels and gold. Qasim was so excited that he forgot the magic words. He ran towards the magic door. "Open, prayed," he said. "Nothing happened. Please open the door." Nothing happened. Then suddenly the door opened and he saw 40 thieves standing in front. Qasim ran as fast as he could. He climbed a tree and hid. Qasim's wife was worried about her husband not coming home. She went to Ali Baba and said, please cheat my husband." Ali Baba went to find his brother. He looked everywhere. He also looked outside the cave. The next day, the thieves returned to the cave. The leader yelled, "Stop!" The bent down and looked at the chocolate pieces. Ali Baba sat in the cave and ate cake while looking for his brother. One of the thieves said that, "I saw Ali Baba at the bakery shop yesterday. Alibaba bought a chocolate cake with the gold coins. That means he knows where we are heading. Now go back to the village and get a carrot and a strong donkey, said the leader. Kasam was still hiding in the tree and was listening to every word and quick come back and told Alibaba the whole incident. The leader of the thieves pulled the donkey cart full of the olive boxes in front of Alibaba's house. The thieves were hiding in these boxes to catch Alibaba. The leader of the thieves knocked on the door. Alibaba opened the door and said, "Oh God, we need olive oil. While they were talking, Alibaba's wife found a dish of sticky cheese and she quickly put the stinky cheese into the olive boxes. The smelly cheese annoyed the thieves so much that they fell out of the boxes and fell to the ground. Alibaba had already called the police, who were hiding inside Alibaba's house, and they caught all 40 thieves and took them to jail. The police accompanied Alibaba to the cave. Then they brought all the treasure back to the village. He returned all the jewels and money to their rightful owners. Everyone was very happy and celebrated with a big party.